Kansas Wildlife and Parks biologists constantly monitor our fish and wildlife resources. State fish hatcheries present unique challenges since large numbers of fish may be threatened by conditions that can change literally overnight. When a strange winter anomaly occurred recently at the Pratt fish hatchery and nearby fishing areas, biologists were quick to spot and correct a potentially significant problem.
We had a strange occurrence at the Pratt fish hatchery a week or so ago. Started noticing dead and dying catfish in some of our brood ponds, and we collected some of them and looked at them in the lab and noticed they had gas bubbles under their skin and behind their eyes causing Popeye. So we immediately went and checked the dissolved oxygen levels in the ponds and found out they were about 300% saturation, which was causing the gas bubble disease in the fish. I'd never seen this in the 30 or so years I've been here, and it could possibly have been happening in some of the farm ponds in the area too. It was kind of the opposite of winter kill. It was winter kill because of too much oxygen instead of too little oxygen.
Air bubbles in the fins and under skin created pressure on internal organs, killing some fish. Plant photosynthesis taking place for weeks under thick, clear ice created oxygen that could not escape, and the saturated oxygen moved by osmosis directly into fish tissues. The fix was easy, but it required immediate action. Ice was broken with a backhoe bucket, and a large water pump was used to disperse dissolved oxygen for several hours in each pond. Once the oxygen levels normalized, remaining fish were out of danger. This random event illustrates the importance of biologists using scientific knowledge to help manage Kansas resources. Always on the lookout, Kansas Wildlife and Parks helps ensure the best hunting and fishing for all Kansans. I'm Mike Blair for Kansas Wildlife and Parks.